In this first talk, we'll discuss the difference between gross primary product, net primary product or net ecosystem product, and respiration of autotrophs, or in terms of an ecosystem, respiration of the ecosystem. So we'll basically be going through the definitions and describe what each one means. Primary product, or GPP, is all of the energy that gets harnessed from the sun by plants and other heterotrophs. So these are all organisms that can take in energy from the sun and produce sugars through a process called photosynthesis. And these producers, many of them are plants that are on land, but there's also algae, phytoplankton in water that can also harness this energy from the sun. So in the process of photosynthesis, you have carbon dioxide, which is in the atmosphere, and the carbon dioxide reacts with water, and plants can take up this water through their roots or also get some from the atmosphere as in terms of vapor. The sun is a catalyst which causes this reaction to proceed, and this carbon dioxide and water gets converted into a sugar. And this is a general equation or a formula, for a sugar and oxygen. So in the process of photosynthesis, carbon dioxide is consumed and oxygen is created, and sugars are also created and stored up in the plant, or they can be consumed within the plant. But basically, the sugar then is inside the plant or phytoplankton or algae. In a plant on land, this takes place in the leaves of the plant or in the stem of a plant, and anything that's exposed to the sun, so anything that has that sun to catalyze the reaction. And we can look at gross primary product for one organism. So you could just study the gross primary product for this tree, or you could look at the whole ecosystem. So all of everything that lives in the system, the grasses and the other trees and the animals and everything that's living here. So plants and other producers, they respire just like us. And that's the thing we often forget. So just like we breathe in oxygen and we breathe out carbon dioxide, plants also do the same thing. So they can go through the photosynthesis reaction whenever they have sunlight, but they also go through respiration. And respiration is just the reverse of photosynthesis. So with respiration, the plant is and anything that goes through respiration, it breaks down the sugars that it's stored, which react with oxygen. And then this creates carbon dioxide and water, and energy is given off in this reaction. So just like when you eat a candy bar that's made of sugar and you breathe in oxygen, you can break down the sugar in that candy bar and it will give you energy and you'll release carbon dioxide and water. So the plants are doing the exact same thing. So why do they need to do this? Well, they need to burn the same sugar so they can power their cells just like we do, and to create new plant tissue. And so they're always having, as they grow, they're creating new plant tissue, or they're also restoring and healing from any injuries to the plant. Respiration takes place in the roots, leaves, and stems of the plant. So it takes place underground and above ground. And then at night, respiration is the only thing that's taking place because photosynthesis stops. Of course, we can't have photosynthesis if there's no energy from the sun to catalyze that reaction. And so the easiest time to measure respiration is at night when there's no photosynthesis. And in this case, then you're just looking at how much carbon dioxide is being given off from a system or from a plant, and that tells you how much respiration is taking place. So you can measure the respiration of one organism, which is RA, or again, an entire ecosystem, which is denoted by RE. In an ecosystem or in a single plant, we often want to measure the net primary production or net ecosystem production. So how much biomass is being generated over time? And so in this case, there's two equations that you can look at. NPP is the net primary production for a plant. And so that would be the gross primary production. So how much energy is being harnessed by that plant? And then you subtract out the energy that has to be respired or broken down in order to keep that plant functioning. So the NPP is all of the energy that's harnessed minus the energy that has to be expended to grow new plants and to power the plants to keep them alive. And the same is true if you look ecosystem-wide. So then you have NEP, the net ecosystem production, is all of the energy that's harnessed by producers in that ecosystem minus all of the respiration that takes place in that ecosystem. So in this picture here, you can think of NEP is the mass in the field at the end of the season. So how much biomass was created or grown up minus the mass that was there at the beginning of the growing season. So at the beginning, you just had little corn seeds or little corn stubble in the field, little corn shoots, I should say, not stubble, the shoots coming up. And then by the end of the season, you have these really tall corn plants. And so you can see that there has been a large increase in mass of corn over the growing season, and that is measured and accounted for with NEP, net ecosystem production.